As the world awaited the verdict in the Derek Chauvin murder trial this spring, a Minneapolis painter waded into the middle of the uncertainty and anxiousness outside the Hennepin County Government Center and began to paint. You may remember seeing and hearing Sean Garrison on KARE 11 and MSNBC that day. And now he's set to unveil a new project that will bring new meaning to that historic afternoon. For weeks now, this small recording studio inside Powderhorn Park has produced a lot of music. Born.
Can't believe.
Of raw emotion.
It's been hundreds of years and we still can't breathe. Please, God, please.
For artist Sean Garrison, it's meant putting some painful feelings.
Please set us free.
On public display.
I don't want to be nobody's strange fruit on poplar trees.
Paint is typically the way Sean communicates his emotions, no matter how big they are.
You're gonna have the Mona Lisa in North Minneapolis.
And he's best known for using his love for art to uplift the community.
So that's what I hope, is that some folks can see this and pick their head up.
But ever since the murder conviction of Derek Chauvin, his mind has been taking him back to the day of the verdict. We followed Sean that afternoon as he set up outside the government center, ready for anything, but expecting the worst.
I can remember precisely how I felt from the time I set up to the time it was done.
Woo! In addition to capturing those feelings on canvas in real time with his painting Walking on Air,
hey,
Sean has spent the last few months working to tell the story of that historic afternoon in a new way.
The energy, the emotions that I went through, what I felt from the people, how do I condense that in 1 hour?
This Friday, Sean will do exactly that with Heaven or Hell, a live painting experience with its own unique
I don't want to die
soundtrack.
But I just want to stop asking why.
What is it about that time that brought you back there?
Just the meaning of it. That okay, maybe there is a sliver of something here that we can build on. Peace and elation and jubilance, and I think it's relief. Justice has finally found its soul. But in order to keep believing, you have to keep feeding it, right? It's like the good and the bad, you know, we are what we decide to feed.
And this time, he's not doing it alone.
But he called and he said, hey, you know, do you think the kids can put together a soundscape?
Tim Wilson and Roberta Ryan run the creative arts studios inside Powderhorn.
The eighth note is called our what?
We're teaching engineering.
Octave, good job.
We're teaching songwriting. We're teaching how to take apart the studio and put it back together again.
And all of it was child's play compared to this latest assignment.
An hour-long song is a lot harder to make than it is to envision.
Dom Milley and Mickey Breeze are professional producers.
You're creating something, right?
And part-time instructors who worked with the students on the project.
Revisiting emotions is one thing. We want to create a new experience as well.
Yes.
That shouldn't be a problem.
I honestly didn't believe it.
Thanks to the contributions of 15-year-old Mateo Ellens and his classmates.
Our experiences go into the music. So I took my anger out in some parts. You could hear me yelling.
It's a source of pride for me.
17-year-old Milo Bergen says literally playing through his emotions on guitar has been a highlight of an otherwise difficult year.
For me, music has been kind of a means of escape.
The reason why we fight this, you know, for justice, the reason why we fight for education or whatever it is, at the end and the beginning of the day, it's about these young people. When they inject their energy into this, it's a beautiful thing because, you know, now they're taking ownership. It's like, you did this. This is part of you as well.
Well, in the past 2 years, everybody's been a raw ball of emotion.
I want just like everyone to feel like how I felt. A roller coaster of emotions.
And they're all anxious to see how it moves the man with the brush.
I'm excited to see what Sean does, what emotions it gives him when he does the painting. Like, that's what I'm really excited for.
I'm aiming for some tears as part of this. I'm aiming for it. Quite often, people don't respond with as much fervor out of love than they do out of hurt and pain. If we responded out of love, and felt that everybody deserved a fair shot as humans, then we wouldn't be having this conversation.
Are you still as hopeful as you were?
Oh, definitely. That's what keeps me going. That keeps me waking up, because if we don't have hope, then, you know, why we do what we do.
As I mentioned, Heaven or Hell, a live painting experience, is coming up on Friday. It will take place at 6 p.m. inside the Kohl's Center for Dance and the Performing Arts in Minneapolis. Tickets are free, but seating is limited, and you need to register online. You can go to care11.com for more information.